Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't think we need a microphone, actually. Can you hear me quite clearly?
Yes.
I don't think we need the microphone. Well, first of all, welcome to The Vine, and a warm welcome and an introduction to the Hampshire Regency dancers. And to our players, who are very lucky this year, we've got live music. So these are the Hampshire Regency players. And for the next half hour or so, we're going to show you some of the dances that would have been popular 200 years ago. We're going back to the time of William and Eliza Shute. They, of course, knew the Austin family quite well. You may have heard the introduction to the associations between the Austens and the Shutes. Now, we don't really know. We think that Eliza herself wasn't particularly keen a dancer, because when she first married William, she was worried unless, when she attended the ball at the Basingstoke Assembly Rooms, she was going to have to lead the first minuet. So I don't think she really liked being on show. But certainly Jane herself liked dancing, and of course in those days that was the only way you could meet people. Unfortunately, we don't know what sort of dances that Jane was dancing, or indeed Eliza was dancing, because none of them wrote anything in their novels, or indeed their diaries, as to what dances. But we've put a little programme together for you, just to demonstrate the types of dancing that they were dancing 200 years ago. Of course, the most common form of dancing was what we call country dancing. And that's where ladies and gentlemen form long waist sets for as many as will. And you've probably seen a lot of that on the film and television programmes. But the more studied dancing at that time, at the latter part of the 18th century, and something that Jane herself was very fond of, was the cotillion. And so we've included a rather nice cotillion, which is a little square formation of dancers. And then we're going to end with another country dance. There's only six, but of course in those days it would have been a long row of people. And that dance is called A Trip to Dunkirk. They've all got funny little names, but quite often popular resorts or towns had a dance named after them. Anyway, after that, there'll be a chance to try a dance out for yourself. So you've been prepared, and do come and join us if you like. Because this is a rather narrow, small room, can I just make you aware, just to keep an exit there for people who want to walk through the room and continue on throughout the house, that would be great. And just again, if you can bear in mind the fragility of these houses, not to lean against things or to put your baggage and clothing where it shouldn't be. Anyway, I do hope you enjoy the dances, and ladies and gentlemen, the Hampshire Regency Dancers. Thank you. and it dates from 1799. And you can get some idea of how the dancers worked. Because the number one couple and the number two couple change over. And if you're number one, you go down the set. If you're number two, you come up the set. But it does mean that you dance with every other couple in the room, and that's what it was all about in those days. Now, the next dance today is going to be quite different. It's called a cotillion, and it would have originated from France, which is far more formal dancing. Jane Austen actually wrote to her niece, Fanny, when her niece sent her some music for the later fashionable quadrille, but she wrote that she much preferred the cotillions of her own day. And they're delightful little pieces, but we're going to dance this one. It's called Les Matadors. This was probably danced in many of the assembly rooms, possibly here at places. Ladies and gentlemen, a trip to Dunkirk.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's now your turn, because we're going to invite you to come and join us to try some of these dances for yourselves.
Well, you are looking down towards the window, then you are the first couple. If you are looking up at me, you are a second couple. The first couples will work from here down to the window, and the twos will work up the set towards me. So the dance starts with the first couple taking inside hands. You are going to dance through the second couple that you joined hands with just now. Then the man is going to go behind the man's line and come back to his place. And the lady is going to go round behind the lady's line and come back to her place. So off you go, down, drop hands, and that's what we call casting back to place. Alright, now the second couple, you're all going to look up at me, you're going to join inside hands. You are going to do the same, you're going to come up, the man is going to cast round behind the man's line, and the lady behind the lady's line. Okay. Now the only thing I didn't include in that is the two hand turns. So let's do it now as it will be in the dance. First couple, inside hands, go through the second couple, come back to place, and when you arrive, two hand turns. Second couple, come up through the ones, cast, back to place, and do a two hand turn. Now we're going to do a move that you probably saw us do in one of our dances. We did it slightly different. It's called a poussette. So you all need to join two hands, and this first man, you are going to pull your lady around. You're going to change places with the second couple. It's like a back-to-back with partners. So you've changed places. Now you are going to continue so that you come back to where you were. That is a hold. Now we need to progress the dance. So first couple, you are going to change places with your partner, passing right shoulders. So cross over the set. Go down below the second couple. Second couple move up. Now you are on the wrong side. So it's not just once all the way down, it's one and a half. So two hand turn, one and a half to get you all the way down. And then the other half to get you on the right side. Okay? Right, you've all progressed now. So ones look down to see the new twos that you have. And straight away, ones, don't drop hands when you're doing that two-hand turn, because you go straight through the twos, cast back to place, and a two-hand turn. Ones, you're coming up through the twos, coming up through the ones, cast, and a two-hand turn. Now you're doing the post-poussette, so everybody join two hands, you're going anti-clockwise around this couple you're dancing with. Now the progressive movement, so cross right shoulders, down below the twos you're working with, and the two-hand turn one and a half times to get you all the way around. We're doing one more time. First couple, we've got a new first couple in here, so join inside hands, and go down between the twos, cast up. When you get back to your place, do a two-hand turn. Twos, you're going to come up through the ones, cast, back to place, and a two-hand turn. You're now going to set anti-clockwise, so everybody with two hands, change places, and again to get back to where you belong. Now to progress, first couple, cross over right shoulders, cast down below the twos, and a two-hand turn one and a half times round, so that you get up. Alright, well done, that's looking good. Come back to where you started so you know those familiar faces again.
I was going to
see the faces,
but nobody
could not allow. It's called La Bella Sombre. There will be honours for you. So ladies, it's a very, you drop your eyes and just drop a very gentle curtsy. You don't look your partner in the eye, that's just too bold. But gentlemen, you can do a bow and have a good look at your partner. Okay. All right, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.